movements. Endogenetic movements. Endogenetic movements means internal movements. Endogenetic means internal. That what is happening inside the earth? What movements are taking places inside the earth? So that we are going to study in this chapter. Endogenetic means internal. Now, like earthquake, volcanic eruption, these are all internal movements. So these we are going to study in detail. Now, see in your textbook, lesson number 2, read the following news about the Nepal which given is there. Nepal devastated, 2 big tremors, 7.9 Richter scale, 11.40 AM. That is the first earthquake which happened in Nepal was of 7.9 on Richter scale. Then it was of 6.6 Richter scale, which came on 12:19 PM. And the epicenter of the earthquake was Lamjung in Nepal. Powerful earthquake rocks Nepal, nearly 1500 killed. A powerful earthquake measuring 7.9 on Richter scale struck Nepal today. Nearly 1500 people were killed and over 1000 people injured in the disaster. The quake and a series of serious aftershocks delivered a severe blow to Nepal. The tremors were also felt across vast stretches of East and Northeast India. It was also felt in China, Bhutan, and as far as Pakistan and Bangladesh. The earthquake with epicenter at Lamjung, around 80 kilometers northwest of Kathmandu, had its impact in several cities in Bihar, West Bengal and Uttar Pradesh. The initial report said the tremor measured 7.9 magnitude. It said the quake hit at 11:40 AM local time at a shallow depth of 11 kilometers. There were 17 major aftershocks measuring over 5 in the next 2.5 hours, said an officer of the National Seismological Center. Another aftershock measuring 6.6 hit within 80 minutes of the quake. This is the largest earthquake in Nepal after 80 years. India has sent rescue teams immediately. Now, this was the condition of the internal movement which happened. That these internal movements, these are natural. And it happened suddenly. So, this was the condition of Nepal on 25th April. Now, there was a great loss of life and property. We are seeing that how many buildings they have been destructed. So many people, 1500 people were killed. And this was the condition of a Nepal when earthquake had taken place. So this we are going to study in this chapter. Now the following questions are there. You go through it and try to answer it. What caused the large scale casualty? Casualties means the what happened? Due to what these casualties had happened? That is due to earthquake. Then what was the magnitude of the earthquake? See, the magnitude means it is given 7.9 on Richter scale. So like this you are going to answer this question. So try to solve it. Now see in your textbook. Various natural events occur on the earth from time to time like floods, storms, earthquake, volcanic eruption, snowfall, extreme rainfall, etc. And similarly, because of these earth movements, because of the movements below the earth's surface, natural events like earthquake and volcanic eruptions occur. For the organisms living on the earth, these events are disastrous. There is loss of life and property because of natural calamities. And this lesson, we get introduced to these endogenetic movements. That in this lesson we are going to study about these internal movements which is caused there inside the earth. Now turn the page, students. See on page number 10. Now see the activity which is given to you, that you can do it at your home. Just take one table, arrange your book notebooks over there and place 3 to 4 objects on it. Then like chalk, duster, sharpener, razor, whatever is there with you. And then take out a notebook without affecting the others. See the activity which is given. And try to do it. you will see that how the tremors of the earthquakes happen. Now see the geographical explanation. Earthquake and volcanoes occur because of this instability in the interior of the earth. Now what is earthquake? What is earthquake? It is sudden tremors or shaking. Sudden tremors or shaking of the earth's crust for a few seconds. So this is the definition of earthquake. You just note down in your book because it is not given there in your book. So what is an earthquake? Sudden tremors or shaking of the earth's crust for a few seconds. Tremors means the shaking. That is, एकदम जो भूकंप के झटके महसूस होते हैं, एकदम ऐसे लगता है कि कुछ हिल रहा है. That are the sudden, because it happens suddenly. Earthquake came suddenly. It doesn't inform you कि मैं आ रहा हूँ. You be prepared. No, it is sudden. That's why sudden tremors or shaking of the earth's crust, that the in the interior of the earth, we have seen in the earlier classes about the interior of the earth, the crust, mantle and the core are there. So that interior of the earth gets shaken and then the disasters happen on the upper surface of the earth. So students, note down this definition as it is not given there in your textbook. Earthquakes and volcanoes occur because of the instability in the interior of the earth. This instability is created due to the movement occurring in the earth's interior. That these internal movement, they take place by because of the instability, because the interior of the earth, it is not stable. Due to the instability in the interior of the earth, these all internal movement, these all endogenetic movements takes place on the surface of the earth. Generally, the movement in the earth's interior occur in the upper layer of the mantle. As I told you that the interior of the earth, it is divided into three parts, that is crust, mantle and core. We have studied it. Now, I am not going to do it in detail. So, tremendous energy is released by radioactive materials which is present in the interior of the earth in the mantle. That the mantle which is there in the interior of the earth, it contains radioactive elements. And that radioactive elements, the tremendous energy is released by these radioactive elements. And these energy waves, they travel from one place to another. And due to such a flow of energy, instability is caused in the mantle. As instability is caused in the mantle, it will have effect on the other parts of the interior of the earth, and due to that effect, the upper part of the surface of the earth will get affected, and these internal movements will take place on the surface of the earth. The movements are classified on the basis of their velocity, direction and landform. Now see the table which is given in your textbook on page number 11, that is classification of internal movements. Velocity. Velocity means the movements which there are slow movements which occur continuously, like formation of mountains and continents. Sudden movements which are in the form of events like earthquakes and volcanoes. Direction means your horizontal or vertical, that is horizontal movement, upward, downward movement. Landform means your continental building, that is creating continents, plateaus and highlands. And mountain building, that is folding and faulting. Now one by one we will study these movements. Now see the slow movement. The effect of slow movement can be seen in the form of formation of mountains and continents on the earth's crust. This can be explained as follows. See again the second table, the effect, pressure and the tension. the direction of wave movement, when waves moves towards each other, when the waves are this, the wave is coming from this side and this wave is coming from this side, then the pressure will be like this, and the tension means when the waves are moving away from each other. Then what will be the effect on hard rock? When the waves are moving towards each other, what will happen? One surface will go down and the other surface will come above. When there is a situation of a tension, that is when the waves are moving away from each other, what will happen? Again, the fault, the one surface will be above and another surface will be below. Then what will be the effect on the soft rock? Soft rock will try to move like wave, when it will be a pressure over there. But when a condition of tension is there, what will be the effect on soft rock? They will get distracted. Wo toot jayenge aur alag alag ho jayenge. Now see the activity. Take a 30 cm long paper strip. Place your hands on both the ends of the strip. See in your picture, it is given there. Now move both the hands towards each other, giving pressure on the strip. Then see what will happen. Now in activity 1, the strip was moved by placing hands on both the hands, both ends. The work performed on the strip at that time is called compression. When you will place the hand, that is a compression. When the pressure was given on the center of the strip from both the ends, that is when the pressure was given, what happened? As a result, the strip moves and folds are formed. You see? In figure 2.5b, the fold is formed. So, due to pressure on the strip, so like that, when the pressure is caused on the earth's move, on the earth's surface, the earth's crust movements are generated and folds are formed in the mountains. So, this is how the fold mountains are formed. See, on page number 12, energy is transformed from the interior of the earth. That is, from the interior of the earth, the energy is transformed, and due to this energy, a pressure is caused on the horizontal part, on the horizontal direction of the layers of the soft rocks which are there. And due to that pressure, the folds start to form. And as this is happening continuously, it is not for one day, one week or one month. It is happening continuously. And the one day, it takes the shape of a fold, and that mountain is called a fold mountain. Now see the explanation in your book. Energy is transferred from the interior of the earth. Because of these energy waves and pressure working towards each other and in horizontal direction, the layers of the soft rocks form folds. If the pressure is very high, large scale folds are formed and their complexity increases, and as a result, the surface of the earth gets uplifted and the fold mountains are formed. Like the Himalayas, Aravallis, the Rockies and these and Alps are the major fold mountains. So, this is how the fold mountains are formed. Now, in our, so this much is okay. Clear? Then, when the energy is transformed from the interior of the earth, जिस तरह से जब एनर्जी जो हमारे इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ से ट्रांसफॉर्म होकर अपर सरफेस पर आती है, तो अपर सरफेस पर आने के बाद क्या होता है, वहां पर उस सॉफ्ट रॉक पर एक प्रेशर क्रिएट होता है. उस प्रेशर के क्रिएट होने के कारण क्या होता है कि वो सॉफ्ट रॉक ऊपर की ओर इस तरह से उठने लगता है, और उठते 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 वो इस तरह से फोल्ड फॉर्म करता है. दिस इज योर तो ये प्रेशर के कारण जो है इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ उठकर एक फोल्ड फॉर्म करता है, और एंड फाइनली इट टेक्स द शेप ऑफ द फोल्ड माउंटेन. सो दिस इज हाउ द फोल्ड माउंटेन्स आर फॉर्म.